Kate Beckinsale, my unequivocal number one in this world, was last spotted with Machine Gun Kelly.
Yes.
Kate Beckinsale is otherworldly hot. She is on another stratosphere. She's sexy, but she's beautiful. She's hot, but she's pretty. She went on Jimmy Kimmel and talked about like watching gangbang porn and stuff like that. She's a real one. And she's aging backwards. She's got the Fountain of Youth along with J-Lo and Christie Brinkley and all them. And there's a certain level of behavior that needs to be maintained from everybody in their respective part in this big process that we call life. And if you don't behave accordingly, the whole process falls apart. The whole system goes to shit. Pete Davidson, he was like a pseudo friend at one point. I texted with him. I went to his show. We went backstage. We talked a little bit. And then he kind of went into another level of fame with these girls. But I was happy because it was like, I kind of know Pete. And wow, it felt like he's a funny guy from New York City who pulled the hottest chick in the world. How could you not root for that? Well, now his best friend, Machine Gun Kelly, is getting in there, which is a weird dynamic, by the way. They're very good friends. What a friendship. What a tag team that is. They're both like 9-foot-tall, lanky, angsty guys. She has a type.
Kate has a type.
She certainly has a type. And I'm not going to begrudge anybody who has a type, but I'm going to begrudge the shit out of Kate Beckinsale here. I'm not hating on MGK. I don't really know MGK. I wrote about him when he battled Eminem. I think he lost that battle, but he did a good job of bursting onto the scene mainstream-wise with that. He was in Bird Box. He's acted a little bit, had a couple songs. You know, he's more famous than me, more successful than me, no doubt. I'm just saying that there are certain guys that should only be matched up with certain girls. It's like, it's just not a fit. And you're not fully understanding the consequences here, okay? Because there might be some simpletons out there who say, hey, KOC, this is a good thing for regular guys, because if Kate Beckinsale is slumming down here, well, that means other hot chicks beneath Kate Beckinsale, well, they're going to fall even lower to average guys like us. Like, there's a trickle-down effect.
That is some wishful thinking.
But it could happen. It could maybe happen. But the likelihood, the more likely scenario is actually nuclear holocaust and the end of the world as we know it, okay? Because again, we are talking about a very delicate ecosystem. Men and women, Venus and Mars, the courtship process, the sex process, the marriage and baby process, that is what makes the fucking world spin. That is what keeps humanity going. And if Kate Beckinsale is going to step out of her tier, the whole system falls apart. So think about it. Kate Beckinsale is like number one in the world type hot. Beautiful girl. If she should operate on the billionaire, 100 millionaire, and super famous level. It should either be Brad Pitt and Leonardo DiCaprio, or it should be the creator of an app who's literally worth billions. Some Mark Cuban shit. That dude we know who owns Patron and he's racing Formula One cars and private jets, and you are living the most lavish, enjoyable life possible.
Like, who
right?
did the Snapchat guy end up with?
Miranda Kerr.
Miranda Kerr, right.
Yes,
right,
she
right.
did it right. Selma Hayek, she dates a billionaire. She did it right. If I'm a hot girl, a regular hot girl, and I look and say, Kate Beckinsale is only pulling MGK? I'm not going to the gym anymore. I'm not doing 50,000 squats. I'm not eating kale for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Because if I look like her, all I can get now is him. And again, MGK probably got more money than most people. But if we're comparing hot, super, super hot, and other famous hot, there needs to be direct correlation and direct connection between level of fame and good looking. Because if those girls see that, if I look as good as Kate Beckinsale, I can't pull top notch guys, I'm not going to bend over backwards anymore. I'm not even going to try. And more importantly, you think about the motivation of man and the reason why people even are billionaires or they are innovating and creating and inventing. And it's because they're trying to get pussy. Okay. The only reason Zuckerberg is out here making face smash is because he wanted to bang that Asian girl. Okay? And so, if being a billionaire no longer guarantees you women like Beckinsale. Well, fucking Uber doesn't exist. The top-notch apps no longer exist because there's no longer any motivation for those guys to sit there and code for hours and build a company and pour blood, sweat, and tears into the next level invention because Kate Beckinsale is no longer the prize. Everything falls out of whack. The hierarchy, the food system, it's a food chain. It's like the like when the meteor hit, right? The meteor hit the planet. And then there was the nuclear winter, and that killed the plants, and that killed the herbivores, and then that killed the carnivores because there's no plants to eat, so the herbivores died. There was no herbivores to eat, so the carnivores died, and everything becomes extinct. Right now, Kate Beckinsale slumming it and fucking these tall, lanky, not-so-famous guys is the meteor that is hitting. And what happens is it hits the planet Earth, and it kills the motivation of girls to even try to look hot because the goal is no longer, you know, elite billionaires, it's MGK. And then those are the herbivores are dead. And then the carnivores are the men who are trying to create billions of dollars in order to look attractive. They're like, well, what's the point anymore? Because Kate Beckinsale is only going to fuck the tall guy with tattoos. So they're dead. And next thing you know, women aren't trying to be sexy and hook up. Men aren't trying to be breadwinners and innovating the world. And everything as we know it falls the fuck apart. You have heads of state who are like, I got millions of nuclear weapons, but we can't go into nuclear holocaust. I want to try to fuck Kate Beckinsale. I am the president of this country. Kate Beckinsale is my dream. Oh, wait, she fucking Machine Gun Kelly? Fucking turn the key, blow this place up. Nuclear holocaust imminent. All because Kate Beckinsale wanted to slum it and get her rocks off with some guy who's 9 feet tall, half her age, and very angsty. She clearly has some type. She's clearly scratching some itch that's in a midlife crisis. And meanwhile, she thinks she's just getting some dick when she doesn't realize she's throwing the world into anarchy and chaos. There's a system. Everybody plays a role in this giant wheel. And take one piece out, everything falls apart. So stop slumming it unless you're going to slum as low as bloggers and podcasters. In that case, slum away and me and you can bang while the warheads are blasting off from Russia. So either fuck billionaires or fuck thousandaires, but that in between is going to be a problem for me and the world as you know it, Kate. Your pussy, it controls the fate of the world. What was the tagline from Heroes? Save the cheerleader, save the world.
Save the world.
Save Kate Beckinsale's pussy from MGK, save the world.